We are in Haridwar. Haridwar means the entrance to Hari. In Sanskrit, Hari means three things. One is thief. Another is Vishnu. Third one is Himalayas. See, Vishnu is okay, Himalayas is okay. But how can the word which is used for thief can be used for Vishnu and Himalayas? It is said, Vishnu and Himalayas, both of them steal your heart. Steal your heart. That is why. Whoever steals your heart, they are called Hari. Whoever steals your heart is Hari. The ultimate
stealing which can happen to you is stealing your mind. The ultimate thing which you can lose, you have only one thing, your mind. Except your mind, you don't have anything else. Be very clear. Even if you have 23-30 acre property, don't think you have that. It's only paper and your mind, feeling that it is your property. It's only paper and your mind, thinking that it is your property. Otherwise, the same 20 acre property, if you go to the register office record, 2,000 people would have claimed it is their property. Whoever steals your heart is Hari. You have only one possession with you, that is your mind. If somebody can steal that from you, you are liberated. So Hari means who can steal the mind or the heart from you. Krishna says in the Gita, among the hills, I am the Himalayas. Among the achala, among the immovable things, I am Himalayas. So, you all have done the whole trip successfully and back to Haridwar. Tomorrow morning, we will do the formal Ganga Snan and offer the Kangana. Kangana means the thread which you had in the hand. Only that needs to be offered in the Ganga. Yajnobhavita and all, if you want, you can keep it. See, Yajnobhavita, Kavi, Rudraksha, cap, the t-shirt, all those things are not connected to any vow. Only the thread which you tied in your hand is connected to the vow which you took. So, only that needs to be put in the Ganges. Other than that, all the things, if you want, you can keep it. Or if you don't want, you don't feel like keeping it, you can put it in Ganga. That's all. But if you keep it with a lot of respect. Do not abuse them. Do not disrespect them. Let me tell you, introduce about this cloth. See, first thing, this cloth which you are having, the Kavi is energized. Second thing, you used this Kavi in the high energy places. So naturally, any energized item will start storing more and more energy when it goes to high energy place. So now it's a high energy cloth. Whenever you are in low mood, mentally, physically, use this cloth on your bed and lie down on that. It will simply bring you again to the high energy in few minutes. So this cloth will be a big protection for you. It will be a big energy support for you always. Keep this cloth. Do not use it for any other purpose. This color is so associated in the collective consciousness with the spirituality and the tradition. So, do not disrespect this color. and the sacred thread and Rudraksha. The sacred thread, if you want to continue the Gayatri, if you chant even for 10 times per day is enough, more than enough. You can wear the sacred thread. If you feel that you will not be able to do or you don't want to do, then you can put that sacred thread also into the Ganges. Nothing wrong. And this Rudraksha also same way. You can use whenever you need the energy. It means 24 hours. 24 hours we need energy. With that itself we are little this way that. Above all, you are carrying an important thing which cannot be expressed by words. That is these beautiful memories. These beautiful memories. Understand, like this orange cloth, like this sacred thread, like this Rudraksha, whenever you are in low mood, whenever you are in low energy, depression or physical pain, bring these memories to your heart and cherish them. Simply even they will lift you to the higher energy. These beautiful memories, they are carrying uncomparable or I can say unexplainable, inexplicable energy in their very memories. The very memories are so powerful. I tell you, if you just sit remembering the Himalayas surrounding and the Ganga flowing, and that is the ultimate meditation, you will be just like a Himalayas. Apuvayamana machala pratishtam. Like a Himalayas established. Whenever I remember Himalayas, just simply the mind disappears. Mind disappears. Even the memory of Himalaya disappears. The object for meditation should have three qualities. One is, it should be able to attract your mind from all other distractions. That is the first quality. Saundarya means it should be so fascinating. Just unconsciously it should be able to take your mind away from all other objects. Next, it should be able to awaken high memories or intelligence in you. Saraswatya means that it should be able to direct you to the higher source. There are some products, some objects which takes away your mind from other objects, but it won't lead up, it will lead. There are some things, it will take away your mind from everything else, but it won't lead up, it will lead down. That's not a meditation object. First thing, it should be able to take your mind away from all other products, all other objects. That's called Saundaryatva. Next thing, Saraswatya. It should be able to lead you to higher intelligence, higher emotions, higher lifestyle, higher values, higher energy, higher things. Third important thing, it should have ability to leave your consciousness when you are flying away, when you are flying beyond that object. Understand, any meditation object can be considered as a perfect object only if it can disappear and into the formless energy when you are ready to fly into the formlessness. It should act as a bridge. When you are ready to jump into the other shore, it should not hold on to your feet. It should let you go. I tell you, Himalayas has got all these three qualities. It will just snatch your mind. Hari. Snatch your mind from all other objects. Second, it will always lead you to higher emotions and higher things, because everything in this hill is associated only with the higher things. It will lead only to higher things. Third, when that need comes, The form of the Himalayas will disappear into the formless energy. It will not bind you. It will not bind you. Whatever object has got these three qualities, that is worthy of meditation. That is worthy of meditation. That is why we use the master's form also as object for meditation. Patanjali says, by meditating on the great master's form, you will achieve the same space in which they are staying. Because first thing, their form is such that it will just snatch your mind away from all other forms. Second thing, they will always lead you to only a higher level. Third thing, when it is necessary, simply they will disappear, leaving you in that space. They will not catch you. They will not be a hindrance. That's why they say, Buddha dies when he leads you to the enlightenment. When he is leading you to enlightenment, he will be holding your hand and leading you. Suddenly at one point he will die. He will not be there. You will feel, oh, what happened, then how will I travel? When he dies, it means now it is time for you to fly on your own, to carry on your own. Actually, when he dies, you will not even have the fear. You will suddenly feel that he is always with you. He is always with you. You won't have the fear that he is not around you or he is not available to you. If you have the fear, it means he has not died. You have killed him. You escaped from him. He has not died. Anyhow, Himalayas has got all these three great qualities of the saundaryatva, sarasvatya, and above all, nirgunatva. When it is necessary, he becomes just formless.
Trust in you, 'cause you know it's best for me to lead a blissful life, a life with no more strife. I can't believe the things I do, just to spend a little time with you. Nothing will compare, I know you will take care.
You're always showing us compassion. Your love is endless like an ocean. Nityananda, Nityananda. My life's become a meditation. Ever since we had a deep connection. Nityananda, Nityananda. Oh, every time I see you, my consciousness expands. Oh, my heart begins to dance. And every time I think of you, I just start to melt.